testimony about a man. His name was James Alexander. Now, I've heard people talk about dying and saying they went to hell and coming back. Somebody handed me a tape one time about a lady, and she claimed to have died, went to hell, a lot of things, and I never even listened to the tape. I'm not saying that didn't or did happen. I don't know. But it just never really done anything for me. But I was listening. There's a testimony that was shared with me some years ago. I cannot prove it. I cannot disprove it. But I felt it when I heard it, that it could somehow give us an idea of just what hell might be like for those that are foolish enough to go there. This young man's name was James Alexander. He lived in the state of Kentucky, the state just north of me. He was a high school senior. He had won a scholarship to play football with the University of Kentucky. They were having a revival in their home church. He was raised by a spirit-filled mother. And they were having revival one spring, and God was moving in the service. James was sitting in the back, and the evangelist felt led to go back and say, "Son, God's dealing with you today." And he looked at him and he said, "Preacher," very respectfully said, "I believe in God. I believe in heaven and hell, and I believe in that. But," he said, "right now, preacher, I've got a life ahead of me to live. I've won a scholarship to the University of Kentucky. I'm going to play ball. I'm going to do my thing, but one day I do intend to get right with God." So he left the revival meeting and went on. He graduated from high school, and that summer he got a job at construction awaiting for school to begin in the fall. But one day on the job, he got seriously ill. They took him to the hospital. They performed a number of tests, and the lady doctor came to his mother with the news and said, I'm so sorry to tell you, but you are in the final stages of leukemia. You don't have very long to live." But this young man, he just would not accept it. And he said, "I'm going to beat this. I'm going to play football. I'm going to live." And sure enough, he got better. He got out of the hospital. He got well enough to go back to the work, to the job, and continued working. But again, he fell ill. They took him to the hospital. I mean, he's dying. He's in the hospital. They've got him hooked up to all kinds of machines. And he's lying there. His mother sitting there in the chair by his bedside in the hospital. And as he lay there, he begins to reminisce about his life. And he says, "My God, I've wasted my life without Christ. And here I am, a dying young man, and it's too late for me to pray." God wasn't needed with him, he felt. And he said, "It's too late for me to pray. I've wasted my life. I'm going to hell." But while I was lying there, and this is the testimony as it was shared with me, he said all of a sudden he felt the strangest feeling and come over him. He knew he was dying. And he said the alarms went off on those machines that they had hooked up to him. And the nurses rushed in and began to work with him. And his mother, they ushered her out of the room. And he said as they ushered her out of the room, he could hear his mama praying, "Oh God, don't let my boy go to hell. God, don't let my boy go to hell." But he said as they worked with him, he said, "I died. I just died." And he said, "As my soul left my body, I looked back down in that bed and saw my body lying there. And those nurses and maybe doctors, but now working, trying to revive me and bring me back to life." And he said, this is what happened. And this is his story, his testimony. He said, "I was carried into the spirit world by demonic spirits." And he said, "They actually chained me." And he said, "Immediately my soul began to descend down to the earth, to the coldest, darkest tunnel you could ever imagine." But he said, "When I came out, it was into a large area." And he said, "As I looked around me into this area and just trying to figure out where I was," he said, "it was a horrible place. But," he said, "I looked ahead of me," and he said, "I saw the largest gates I've ever seen in my life." And he said, "As I stared at those gates, I realized they were the gates to hell." And he said, "I saw that there was an inscription written on them, and I could actually read it and understand it." This is what James Alexander said that he saw. He said, that inscription on those gates read like this: through these gates you pass into the city of woe, into eternal torment, where all hope is gone and lost forever. Help me know. We're about to go on a journey. James Alexander said he began to weep, and said the demons began to laugh. And he said they carried me to the gates of the city of woe. And he said, as I got there, he said, I saw hell. He said, it's nothing like I thought, but he said it was a 7-level pit. And he said each level was a place of torment for various sins upon earth. Now again, I can't prove that or disprove it, but I do know the Bible said that there are various levels of punishment in hell. Some are beaten with many stripes and some fewer. You've read that in the Bible. The rich man said, I am in torment, plural, here in these flames of hell. But he said, as I look at the city of woe and into the very pits of hell, he said, I begin to see what was there. He said the first level of the city of woe was for those who rejected the gospel while on earth. He said just rejected the light of the gospel was their sin. He said millions were here. And he said there was a mist of darkness that burned them, their souls. And he said they were crying and they were blind and could not see because they had rejected the light of the gospel while they were upon earth. And he said that mist of darkness literally burned and tormented them. Then he said all of a sudden those demons carried me to the second level of the city of woe. And he said this level was for those who would not fear God while they were upon earth. He said here you could see, now this is how he described it. He said there was literally volcanoes of erupting, burning lava. You know the Bible talks about fire and brimstone being in hell. And he said that there was a river of burning lava that actually ran through this level of hell. And he said a great wind was blowing so forcefully that it would literally blow these souls of men and women into this very burning river of lava. And said they would scream. Now remember the Bible said, I'm tormented in this flame. And he said they would scream and they'd make their way back to the bank of that river. And they'd climb out and he said they'd wipe that off of them. And when they'd get it off, said that wind would blow them right back into the river again. And they would cry out and say, give me one more chance to fear God. And said the demons would laugh and say, there's no mercy here. You're in the city of woe. He said, we begin to descend to the third level, hell. He said, this level was for those who practice witchcraft, who worship demons, Satan and idols on earth, and for those who were involved in the occult. He said this level was ruled by demons with eyes like coals of fire. And he said the demons would literally look upon the souls that were there and burn them just by looking at them. And they would tear at them with their demonic claws and would laugh at them and remind them how that they had been foolish enough to worship idols while they were upon earth and demons. You know, I've read where Satan worshipers actually offer children up to Satan. And I think, my God, how can that be possible? I know that happens. I'm sure that it is. And people get by with that. They go right along. But listen, you're not going to get by. The Bible said, God is not mocked, for whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. There's a payday coming. Do you hear what I'm saying? I said, there's a payday coming for sin. And James Alexander said that we begin to descend to the fourth level of hell, the city of woe. Listen to this. When I heard this, my heart broke within me. He said, because the fourth level was a place where backsliders and hypocrites were. Backsliders and hypocrites. The only reason I touched my heart, because I had a brother, my only brother. 1978, he died drunk. Away from God. James Alexander said it was a place of memories. Bible says, where the worm dieth not. I personally believe that's the consciousness. I mean, you'll never forget. It'll haunt you for the rest of your life. He said, here fire shot up to the floors and out of the walls of this level of hell. And said the demons would literally coax those souls into remembering how that they had once served God while they were on earth. And said as they begin to remember how that they used to sing the Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. They remembered how that they felt the good presence of God like you and I have felt and experienced Him here this afternoon. That those in hell would cry out and scream and say, I once had the keys to heaven, and I threw them away. He said the demons would laugh about how the souls had been coaxed and cursed into the God. He said, we then went to the fifth level of hell, the city of woe. Listen. He said this level was for sex perverts, homosexuals, lesbians, child molesters, and others. James Alexander said that this level was full of all kinds of sexually transmitted diseases. He could see the effect. He knew that in his conscience. And he said there was a horrible odor that came out of this level that was worse than the smell of dead, rotting human flesh. And he said that there was a river of filth that ran through this level of hell. And that the demons would chain those souls that were there and drag them through this river of filth, stench. And they would scream and say, please let me have some fresh air. Please let me out of here. Please let me breathe some fresh air. And he said that he saw that all these souls that were there, that had lived a life of perversion, that they were suffering from these various diseases. He saw the effects of gonorrhea. He saw the effects of syphilis. He saw them suffering from the effects of AIDS. AIDS because that they had lived such a horrible, wicked, sinful life while upon earth. And you say, is that sinful? It is. But Jesus forgives sin. Can you say amen? Then he said, we descended to the sixth level of the city of woe. And this level was for thieves and robbers. God hates that sin too. I'm glad he forgives you as well. Amen. He said this level was for those who were thieves on earth. And he said it was lit up so bright, the light was almost blinding. And he said the floor of this level of the city of woe of hell was just literally on fire. It was like a burning desert. And he said that these souls would walk through this burning desert, through this fire. And he said that it seemed as if everything here had been stolen out of it. There was not a tree. There was not a rock. I mean, nothing was there. It was just a burning, fiery floor like a burning desert, an empty place. And he said that there was not even a sound here. That sound had even been, like it had been stolen and taken away. And millions, he said, I saw millions wandering through this scorching, burning desert in silence. Then finally, he said, we descended to the seventh level of hell in the city of woe, and it was for murderers. He said, I saw a river of blood that ran through this level of hell. It was like lava. And he said, the souls of those who were there were literally thrown into this river of blood and cast into it. And he said that that burning blood would burn those souls that was there. They were tormented. And he said, I saw that however a murder had been committed on earth, that the individual that committed that suffered that same fate in hell over and over and over again. It could never get out of their mind or their conscience. He said, I saw that there was a man that had cut another man's head off with a wire and then had stabbed him to death repeatedly. And said demons did in the same way. Literally, they'd cut his head off and fall to the ground and go right back home. They would stab him, he would scream. He said there was a man there that had entombed another one on earth and suffocated him to death. And he was going through the same fate. He'd been entombed in hell and was screaming for air to be able to breathe, tormented throughout eternity. And then he said the cry of every person that had ever been murdered upon earth was in that river of blood, crying out of that river of blood, like Abel's blood, crying out in the Old Testament, crying out for revenge. And this young man, he said, I saw this and I began to weep and cry. He said, I don't want to see. And he said, the demons laughed and said, you're not, you're going to the first level. Those who rejected the gospel. He said, we ascended to the first level of hell, the city of woe, and he said, they were ready to cast me in the first level. But he said, but I saw how many more of those gates so fast knocked at the gate. He said, I looked, saw, he saw Jesus, an angel, he didn't know, but he said, he heard the voice of that person that came. Said, let him go. He said, reluctantly, they loosed the chain from him. He said, immediately, I began to ascend, and I found myself in a hospital room, and he said, I still heard my mama praying, don't let my boy go to hell. They revived him. He got saved. I was informed that he got saved and became a Pentecostal preacher and preached the gospel.
Are you a stranger to God? Carried away with your pride? Sinner, do you ever stop and think? Are you afraid to die? Are you afraid? Are you unsaved? Are you afraid to die? Call on him while he is near. Moments are swift passing by. Will you seek him while he still may be found? Are you afraid to die? Are you afraid? Are you unsaved? Are you afraid to die? Are you too wicked to cry? Would you to God's bosom fly? Soon he's coming like a thief in the night. Are you afraid to die? Are you afraid? Are you unsaved? Are you afraid to die? Are you afraid? Are you unsaved? Are you afraid to die?